The first of the three fatal shootings left a teenager dead in this wooded area outside this apartment complex. So far, no arrests have been made in this case or in the other two homicides that followed just hours later.
Just before midnight, here on Indy's Near East Side, a man was shot and killed inside his car after friends and family say he was robbed.
He the type, he don't carry bank cards or none of that. He just stay with a lot of money in his pocket. Basically, people was trying to being greedy, envy, so they shot him and took his stuff.
I love Rick, you know? He was like, he helped me out.
Mercedes was engaged to the victim, who family identified as Ricky Cox Jr., and says the pair were planning to move out of Indiana after they sold their house.
We was about to get married this year, and we was gonna move to Florida.
Just 90 minutes before that shooting, police were called to a duplex on Indy's west side and found another man shot to death. On Sunday afternoon, a teenager died after being shot at the Wildwood Village apartments on the city's near northwest side. IMPD spokesperson Michael Hewitt, who spoke at all three scenes, said none of the crimes appear to be connected aside from the timing.
Something I want to stress is that, like with any area of our city where we do have violence, the majority of the people who are living in these neighborhoods are good people.
Also on Sunday, a 40-year-old man died after being beaten on Friday inside this home on Division Street. For their part, Ricky's friends and family hope all four killers are brought to justice.
I don't know how y'all go to sleep at night. I don't know how y'all do it, but y'all wrong for it, bro. You know, the police gonna do justice, how they gonna do it, but God watching too.
Finally, police did not have good suspect information to give out on any of the four homicides, but anyone with information on those cases can always contact Crime Stoppers.